Hey everybody, this is Roy Kennedy and this is Favorite Game Friday, where we have a group of contributors with completely different tastes in gaming talking about their favorite game and the category of the week. This week we're talking all about games with mass appeal. Is there a game that you feel like works with a huge variety of gamers, maybe from young to old, all sorts of different groups of people who are new to gaming, people who are experiencing gaming? What's a game that has mass appeal? Leave that in the comments down below and let's get to all of our contributors' clips.
Games that we feel work for everybody, from gamers
to
non-gamers. My pick is, going way back in my time machine here, to Stone Age. Watch out! And your pick?
Ticket to Ride!
Choo-choo! Happy Friday. Take care.
Happy Friday, everybody. This week we're talking about games with mass appeal, those kind of games that you can play with anyone of any age, and whether they're a gamer or not really at all.
Well, I think everyone is probably going to love Takenoko. It's a game that looks cute enough that you can play with young children. My girls even call it the panda game. But scratch away at that surface and there's a surprisingly deep game here that gamers are going to enjoy. If they're very young or the people completely new to board gaming get a little confused, you can also move some of the elements, such as taking away the irrigation or the weather effects. So while the box might present a child-friendly, adorable game, it's actually a game that gamers are going to love too.
This week I'm going to go with the Unlock series. This one happens to be the Star Wars themed ones, which we love because we like that theme. But there are lots of different ones to choose from. We have a selection here. Each of the boxes has three different themes in it. So there's plenty of variety for you to pick something that suits those that you're going to play in. There is a little 10-minute learn how to play. There's 10 cards and they get to grips with how the cards work and how they interact with each other. So it's a really easy way to get to learn the game before you sort of dive into the puzzle that you're going to solve. We've played with family that don't play games at all. We've played with older people. There is also a new family edition coming, which will have some that are suitable for those of younger age, although many do say they're suitable from 10 plus. So for us, the Unlock series has been really good for something to play when family get-togethers, and also something that when we've had a games night and we need something to fill, because they're just an hour to solve, well, hopefully, if you've done okay, they make a nice filler for a games night as well, and a bit of a nice change to do something cooperatively.
A game that has mass appeal and has never failed for me is Just One. I've played this with so many different kinds of groups, gamers, non-gamers, kids. This has never failed for me. Just One, a cooperative party game that is fantastic.
Hey friends and gamers, it's your old pal Frenchie. It's good to see you this week. So what are Frenchie's games that have mass appeal? Well, I'm going to squeak three in this week, if you don't mind. First one is Marvel United. Chibi-style characters, the heroes and the villains that are kind of cartoonish. A very good co-op game, a game that kids like, a game that even serious gamers like. And hey, it's Marvel. That's mass appeal in its own right. Then there's Seven Wonders Architects. This is a game that was highly played at the Dice Tower Retreat, and it's set in the Seven Wonders universe, which in itself is popular. Very easily taught, very simplified, very stripped down, and a game that even serious gamers liked this past week. And then one of my personal favorites, which is Dead Man's Draw. That is a press your luck style game in which you're playing cards, turning them over one at a time. If you match, suits your bust. But at any time, you can bring your cards in and score points. But each card is going to do something different. Like the chest and the key will allow you to go ahead and double your points. The cannon will allow you to blast a card from your opponents. The kraken will allow you to take two more cards without any choice. And the hook will allow you to take a card from your tableau and play it strategically. Great game, and I think it has mass appeal because my son loved it, and I think you'll love it too. Anyway, until next week, play nice. Take care.
Hey everybody, I think the key to mass appeal games is all in the theme. So Grayson, I'm going to go through some games with super popular themes, and you tell me if they appeal to you. The first one I have is about the drama of life in a big metropolitan hospital.
No thanks.
What about this one where you're a Mountie catching fur trappers in Canada?
No thanks.
What about this one where you're fighting off evil in a bayou?
No thanks.
What about this one where you're stealing picnic baskets?
No thanks. No thanks. No thanks is like a it's a simple, pretty quick card game where you be where basically all you do is just pass around point cards, and you want to get the least amount of points, so you just put chips on them if you don't want that card when it comes to you.
Yeah, everybody knows games like Uno where there's just cards with numbers on it, and you either like take the card or put a chip on it and say no thanks.
Yep.
Happy Friday, everyone.
Hey guys, this week's topic is a game with mass appeal. To me, that's going to be Ice Cool. I haven't personally played it, but everybody around me who plays it loves it, and I'll take it from Sam Healy's review. If a 5-year-old likes it, and a 40-year-old likes it at the same time, has a great mass appeal. Well, till next time, guys.
For me, I'm going to go with a great party game called Just One. This is a game that can play with all sorts of different people. It's cooperative. You're trying to make words and not pick the same words to help a person guess a different word. It's all one-word things. That's why it's called Just One. But it's a great, fun party game that can be played with a huge variety of different players.
Hello, Proti here, your Romanian content creator, and today's topic is a game with mass appeal, and my pick for today is Just One. Just One is a game that I think fits different situations, different gamer styles, or even non-gamers, and you can play it with children, you can play it with adults, and it's always a lot of fun. It's cooperative, and in the same time, it has that thinky element where you think, okay, what am I putting on this table? What word am I writing down? Because you think, am I going with the obvious? Because nobody would go with the obvious. Or you would say, okay, I will not go with the obvious because somebody maybe is going with the obvious. And then those two clues are getting canceled out. So I think it's a really nice and interesting game, which fits this category of a game with mass appeal. And this is Just One.
Kimberly from Tabletop Tolson here, and when I think about games that have mass appeal, those are games that can reach a large audience with a large age range and people will have a really great experience with. So for me, it's The Initiative. This is a cooperative, code-breaking, puzzle-solving game, and it's just loads and loads of fun, and you can have youngins play, even like adolescents, all the way up to as old as you want. This is a super game. What about you, Joey? Oh, I am right with you, Kim. For me, it's Unlock. This is kind of like an escape room in a box. It takes about an hour, and it's cooperative. You're code breaking, you're solving puzzles together. It's loads and loads of fun.
Hi, I'm Josh from the YouTube channel Josh Yaks, and my pick for a game with mass appeal is Gloomhaven with an orange, because it has mass and it has appeal. Hey? No? Well, fine, get for sale or can't stop or something.
My favorite game that has mass appeal is Illusion. It's sort of like Timeline, but uses colors. At one point, my mom taught it to her mom all on her own.
And it went well. My favorite games with mass appeal are the Tea Dragon Society and Autumn Harvest card games. The graphic novels are also really great. It's chill, it's fun, it's light, it's refreshing, just like a good cup of tea.
Hi, everyone. I'm Nathan, and my favorite game with mass appeal, did you guess? That's right, it's Wits and Wagers, which I don't own Wits and Wagers, but I do have a playmat. Not sure why, let's not get mired down in minutia. Now, Wits and Wagers is a fun guessing game. It's like the first round of The Price is Right. You try and get as close as you can without going over. It's really got a lot of appeal to, I think, it'd work well with all ages and skill levels. Also, quick shout out while I'm at it to Cartographers! Yeah, Cartographers is mass appeal. If you don't think Cartographers is appealing, maybe you're not part of the mass.
Assalamu alaikum. In my opinion, the game that works really well with all age groups is Tiny Towns. It has a very simple bingo-like mechanism that whatever one player chooses, that resource goes to all the players and then they get to place. So that works really well with all the young people. But there is enough certain depth in the game that the adults can enjoy as well and make complicated shapes work on their small board. And that adds such a nice depth to the game that adults can enjoy while children are enjoying converting resources into different building shapes as well. So my choice, which works for all age groups, Tiny Towns. Happy gaming.
Hi, I'm Jenny.
And I'm Ray.
And we're Weber Family Reviews. And games to play anyone. We actually have a lot of games that we play with anyone. This first one here, this is Vegas Dice. This is one of my mother's favorite games. And we've played this with everyone. We take this camping. It lives in my mother's motorhome. And so any age level can play it. You can teach it in a couple minutes.
And then Yam Snap, which is Yahtzee. But scoring is kept track not on a pad of paper, but with poker chips.
Makes it great for traveling. And we played this with my 5-year-old niece. It doesn't require reading, so it's great for a group where you have a lot of different ages.
All right. Happy Friday.
Hi, I'm Ralph from Board Game Nation. Thank you for having us on Favorite Game Friday. Our game of mass appeal, we think this time, is Dixit. It was the Spiel des Jahres in 2010, and with good reason. It has loads of beautifully illustrated cards, gorgeous pictures, loads of expansions, so those cards, you can keep adding to that collection. The rules are quite simple, and so you can play it with Grandma and Grandad, you can play it with little kids. I've actually played it with speakers of English as another language, and it's a really fantastic tool because it comes to you at whatever your level of communication is, while still being beautiful, engaging, and easy to play. Thank you for having me again. Happy gaming.
It's always fun to have some of those games in your collection that can be played with almost anyone. It's cool to see which games really work well with a large group of people or with all sorts of different people. Make sure to leave in the comments down below what game you think has great mass appeal. And thanks to all of our contributors from all around the internet and all around the world. It's awesome having you join in on Favorite Game Friday. And if you want to be a part of Favorite Game Friday next week, we'll be talking about games that get you into the holiday spirit. Maybe there's a certain type of game that you play with friends and family around this type of year, or maybe just a game that feels very like holiday-ish and makes you get into the holiday Christmas spirit. Make sure to leave that in the Google Drive link down below. You can do a super short video and anybody can join in, so you could be a part of Favorite Game Friday as well. Well, thank you so much for joining in. It's been awesome, and I'll see you on the next Favorite Game Friday.